In 1936, the M1 Garand entered service as the standard U.S. infantry rifle, replacing the model 1903 Springfield. And according to General George S. Patton, it was the greatest battle implement ever devised. Stick around, because we're going to get noisy with it. We've noticed a large percentage of our viewers have not subscribed. So if you like what we're doing, please consider subscribing and turning on notifications. It's free, and you can always change your mind later. Thanks for joining us again on Shoot of the Series. My name's Ed Thorell from Firearms Education and Training. We'd like to thank you all for joining us and joining us today at a beautiful day here on the Mystery Range. It's perfect weather. We couldn't ask for better. And we just wanted to thank everybody for watching, tuning in, and continuing to. Anyway, today we're going to be spending a little bit of time talking about an absolute classic, the M1 Garand. And it was a game changer. In 1936, when it entered the U.S. military as the standard military infantry rifle, it was the first semi-automatic battle rifle yet to be introduced. Now, it fires a .30-06, but it's a semi-automatic, and it gave the American infantrymen a huge advantage on the battlefields of World War II over the enemy, which was armed with bolt-action rifles. So because this was a semi-automatic, it had two really good things going for it. First of all, less recoil. Second of all, it could be fired as fast as the soldier could pull the trigger. So it had a lot more firepower. And as I said before, General Patton was a huge fan. So it fires 8 rounds of .30-06 from what's known as an end block clip. Now, we did an earlier video talking about the differences between magazines and clips, and this is definitely a clip. So the way that these things would fire is you start by pulling the operating rod all the way to the rear to where it locks. Now, I'm going to do this with two hands just to make it safer and so that you can see the loading operation. I'm going to hold the operating rod to the rear because as soon as this little device gets to the very bottom, if you're not careful, it's going to release itself, and if your thumb's in the way, you're going to get a case of what they call Garand or M1 thumb, where your thumb gets mashed. I'd rather avoid that. So I'm going to hold this to the rear. I'm going to load this in and push it all the way to the bottom, just like that. And now what I'm going to do is release it. And now the gun is ready to fire. All right, I'm going to put my ears on, and then we're going to make a little noise. The safety is right down here, and when the safety is forward, it is off. When the safety is back, the safety is on. Very similar to the M1A and the M14, or the Mini 14 that you might have seen before. So anyway, let's get lined up on our target. Have some fun. Yeah, buddy. Last one. And what you saw was the familiar twang of the end block getting thrown out of the rifle when the rifle was empty. There you go, the M1 Garand. What's not to like, right? So anyway, you know what else is really easy to like? Shooter shout out. Yeah. Well, that Garand was sure a lot of fun, and it sure did some damage. So, our first shout out of the week goes to John Freitas, finding the right firearm for you. John writes, great info, Ed. Would love to see videos on good options for Southpaws. Well, John, that's a great question. You know, 90% of the guns out there are made for righties, but we'll do a little bit of homework and find out about something for you lefties as well. Thanks, John. We appreciate the comment. The next comment comes from RB.T, and he really enjoyed the Remington 870 20-gauge shotgun. He said, awesome channel. Love your info. Thank you. I need to take your class. All right, RB.T, I appreciate that also. And if you want to find more information, you can check the description box down below for either training or for the Garand. On behalf of Shoot of the Series, my name is Ed Thorell from Firearms Education and Training. We want to thank you all for watching. Be sure to hit the like, the share, and the subscribe button, and we'll see you all next time. Y'all take care.